everyone. This is Assistant Professor Ishani Trivedi from LJ Institute of Engineering and Technology, continuing with the session of the precast construction. So students, in today's session, we are going to talk about the precast concrete connections. Before coming to this session, you must refer the different structural elements like precast floor, that is slab, beam, column, and walls, and then you can refer to the precast concrete connections. Now you already know what is the meaning of a joint, what is the meaning of a connection. Being a civil engineer, we are going to specifically talk about the connections that will be provided in the precast concrete structures. Now the joints and connections will form an integral part of a precast concrete because it is basically joined only with the help of joints, because the elements which will come will be in ready to use condition. The beam, column, slab and walls, they are supposed to be joined together with the help of connections and joints. So for us it becomes a very major important part. Its design considerations, its manufacturing, its availability, and the types of connections and types of joints for the various types of portal frames. Let us first discuss about what is the basic difference between a joint and a connection. Now, you can see over here, I am also flashing an animated image for you that how the joint between two elements, between two precast elements, looks like internally. These are my dowel bars and the joint is provided. So first, if I want to precisely define a joint, then it is the action of forces. Which forces? Tension, shear and compression, that takes place at the two interface between two or more structural members. So the joint is the action of forces between two structural members, while the connection is the action of forces, tension, shear and compression. And it also includes the moments, bending and torsion through an assembly comprising of one or more interfaces. So if I am referring to single joining between two precast elements, then it is a joint. If I am talking about the assembly which comprises of the forces and also the moments, then that type of group of connections, group of joints, then that type of group of joints will be referred to as the connections. Now, what are the main purposes of these connections? We know it, but to keep it precisely, first to transmit the forces between the structural members. Next comes about the resistance, so to provide the stability and robustness, the moment of resistance to the structure. Then next is for the purpose of bolting, welding and grouting. The infill grouting will be done. We have discussed this in the slab. Then for the bolting and welding of two elements. Next I have to resist the applied serviceability and ultimate loads acting on it. And should be also adequate number of joints or connections should be provided to resist in case of any accidents, in case of fire, in case of explosion or any kind of natural calamities. Also note that the joint should be as much less as possible also, and it should be adequate in number to even resist all of these kind of external forces. So together your design consideration of the connections become important. I am showing to you over here, this will be my filling material, the grout material. The rebar which is provided between these two will be known as my dowel bar. This is a column, this is a beam. I'm showing you a joint between a beam and column over here. Now this becomes enlarged when it is a mass concrete structure. So this is my column with the help of corbel support, which we have discussed in previous sessions. And this L-shaped edge beams will be provided. And these are my connection. And these joints all together, this assembly will be known as a connection. We have already studied about this design of beams and columns. Now we are, as I already mentioned, you must refer to that, then you will understand the connections very easily. This is my assembly, this is my 1, 2 and 3 precast elements, precast walls joined together. cast in place infill grouting will be done. These are my connections between these three precast wall. Now let us talk about the first one. Say the design considerations, right? What things have to be considered when we are talking about the connections? So a total of 9 factors comprises of the connection design considerations. What has to be considered? First one, the bond length to the upper column. So this is the best example which we can take. Over here we have the column with corbel support. This is my first story or first floor. So over here the rebars are extending for the next column, next story column. So the first says is the bond length to the upper column. What is the bond length for the upper column? Over here my one beam and column connection is over. Second is the bearing of the upper column, meaning the grouting and the pads of the upper column, which will be done over here. You have to consider that as well. Third, localized bursting reinforcement and links above the bearing. So the reinforcement bars which are extended over here, it is we are talking about the moments due to that, links above the bearing, and over here the plates which will be fixed for the next column and with the beam. Shear and anchorage reinforcement at the end of the beam over here. This is my anchor bars which are provided. Fifth one is dovel action in shear. I already showed to you what is a dovel bar which will be placed between this beams and column. So the dovel action in shear and in bonding, anchorage in negative bending of the top steel above the beam. Next, the grouting compression joint over here between the end of the beam and the face of the column. The compression bearing joint between the beam and the corbel over here. The corbel itself, each of which is individually designed in compiling the design of the connection, and the localized bursting reinforcement and links at the top of the column. These are the main 9 major aspects involved typically in a beam to column connection. There are 4 different types of connections: beam to column and beam to slab and column to foundation. Like, we will discuss them all 4 of them. But for a typical beam to column connection itself, there are 9 design considerations which are to be taken care of. Next, I am going to discuss certain important types of connections. The first which we have is, now students, we are talking about the types of connections, right? So the first one which we have is pin jointed connections or hinge jointed connections. An example of a classical beam column connection, which I am also showing to you over here. This is my connection between beam and the column, the pin jointed connection. So the pinned connections are used in precast structures extensively, and they may be formed in the simplest manner by element to element bearing. The nature of the precast construction lends itself to forming simply supported connections in order to avoid the flexural continuity across the end of the individual elements. For this reason, they are also referred to as joints, as they tend to involve one bearing surface only. Although these are not accepted in certain codes and criteria also, because of the it attempts to create structural frame continuity, pinned connections are seen by precast manufacturers as safe and economical, but there are some controversies in this case. In many cases, for example, say pre-stressed beams, there is no advantage in providing such continuity of walking moment, as the beam itself is fully stressed in that mode. In other cases, like hollow core floors or slab, there is no provision for continuity reinforcement, and very special construction details have to be derived. And hence, however, this is not to say that pin connections should only be considered, but each connection should be judged on its merits, bearing in mind all manufacturing and erection aspects. Now, these pinned connections or hinged connections transfer shear and axial forces, both for the gravity forces and possible uplifting forces due to overturning. They cannot transmit movement and torsion by definition, by theoretical criteria, although in reality there is no such thing that occurs. Small moment of resistance may develop due to interlocking effects of the infill grouting, shear, friction, but these will rapidly exceed in surface and rendering the connection as pinned. Pinned connections mainly occur where vertical and horizontal elements are joined, like a classical beam column connection with projecting rebars. Next, talking about the second type of an important connection. The first one, remember, was pinned connection. The second is movement resisting connection, MRC, referred as MRC, movement resisting connections. Let us talk about the same. So, a movement resisting connection, MRC, is capable of transferring to some degree in plane bending moments, which was not possible in pin jointed connections. So, to overcome that, we have MRC. The torsional moments often accompany the bending moments, which we have already talked in past. That the basic concept of MRC, movement resisting connection, is shown to you over here in this figure. I have taken it. Continuity of movement is affected by the transfer of axial forces over here. Because the precast connections are usually erected as pinned joints, it is only the end moments from imposed loads which are carried by the MRC. Great care must be taken in detailing and constructing connections to the moment resisting connection, and the site operative should not be given the choice whether to insert or not a vital element and to make the connection or not, and it should be included in the part of design itself. For example, if additional bolts to those required for temporary stability are necessary to form MRC, it is possible the site operative may omit them or insert them under strength bolts. A similar situation arises where welding is required to form an MRC. Location where such connections are made, or let us say that the features of these type of connections are, first one, it stabilizes and increases the stiffness of the portal and skeletal frames as compared to pin jointed connections. It reduces the depth of flexural frame members. It distributes second order movement in beams and slab and hence reduces the column movements. And it improves the resistance to progressive collapse as well. I have talked about progressive collapse in short in the previous sessions. Okay students, now let us move forward with the types of connections based on the structure. So based on the structure, based on the precast concrete elements, as I said that I will talk about four types of major connections. First is beam to slab connection, beam to column connection. Second, third is wall to frame connection, and fourth is column splices, column joints including to foundations. These are the four main types of connections. The previous I told you was about the acting, the mechanism of the connection, but based on the structural concept, the types of connections for us for precast concrete construction are the four types. I have taken over here an example. This is a column. With column, I have the connection of a hollow core slab. This hollow core slab means the beam and slab connection, the column and slab connection, sorry, column and beam connection, the beam column connection at the face and beam column connection at the head. This will also become two different type of connection if we talk about beam and column connections. So this is my full assembly of a connection of a beam, column and slab. Likewise, the column will be also connected to the foundation pockets. So that also becomes my integral type of a connection. Let us talk about major structural connections between beams, columns and foundation in the skeletal frames. So I have the first one, beam to column face. See, I told you already that we will have two types, beam to column face and beam to column head. So this type of connection which you can see over here is my beam to column face connection. This is my beam to column head connection. the name itself specifies. Then I have column base plate to the foundation. Then I have column to pocket foundation for isolated foundation. Then I have column to doweled foundation. Dowel bar will be provided with between column and foundation. That is my next type. Hence, so these are the major structural concerns, structural connections for us, which can be designed and we have to take care of while you are providing precast concrete structures. Next, let us talk about the several factors on which the design consideration depends. The design philosophy depends on first factor, the stability of the frame. The unbraced frames require moment resisting foundations where the braced frames do not. So the braced frames can contain pin jointed column splices, otherwise MRC has to be provided. Next, the structural layout of the frame. The number and available positions of columns and bracing elements may dictate a connection design. Depends on the structural layout of the frame. Third, moment continuity at ends of the beams. So the cantilevered beams always require moment resisting end connections, while the simply supported beams do not require the same pin jointed, or it can use rigid or semi-rigid end connections. Next, fire protection to important bearings and rebars. Next, we have is appearance of the connection and minimizing the structural zones. For example, hidden connections must be designed within the dimensions of the elements, while the visible connections are the outside element. For example, dowel bar, dowel joint, dowel connection is one type of a hidden connection, while the base plate which is provided is a visible or external connection. And last, you should achieve the ease and economy of the manufacture, as this will be manufactured in bulk and hence economy has to be achieved, which is a factor of any kind of design. Next, the connections. How do you provide the connections? See, we have talked about the design, we talked about the various elements which are available for the connections. So how you are going to provide these connections? There must be certain types and procedures as well. So according to Indian Standard 15916, revised in the year 2010, it was also later revised in the year 2011, the standard procedures which is provided to us for achieving the connections are: first one, welding of the plates or the projecting steel. We have discussed about welding in the previous sessions. Second is pre-stressing. Third is epoxy grouting. Epoxy resin or epoxy material can be used as the grouting material. Then we have overlapping reinforcement loops and linking steel grouted by concrete of the equal strength or say similar. Then we have polymer slurry grouting at the dowel cast joint, bolts and nut connection. Bolting and nut connection we have discussed in the past sessions, you can refer that. And the reinforced concrete ties all around the slab. These are the various specifications suggested according to Indian standard codes for providing the connections. Last, we will discuss about one important type of joint in the precast concrete which you need to consider. You must be aware with the expansion joints. You know what is the work or what is the purpose of the expansion joint. It is a control joint. It is a gap which allows the concrete to expand and contract as the temperature changes. Now, it has to be provided in the precast concrete structures according to Indian standards. It forms a break between the concrete and the other part of the structure to allow the movement without any kind of damage due to thermal expansion, due to temperature changes or so on. It is designed to absorb the expansion and contraction of construction material, also absorb the vibrations due to ground shaking, due to earthquakes or any kind of soil movement. You can see over here we have a concrete expansion joint. I have taken various graphics for you to understand. It is generally provided between sections of slab in say floor and in bridges. You also know that these are provided in railway tracks as well and piping system. For us, in precast concrete structures, expansion joints must be provided with appropriate sealant, polysulfide sealants in the bridge sections and the slab sections to avoid any kind of such disturbances or to say safely transmit these disturbances. That is why you need to give focus to expansion joints specifically in precast concrete structures. Alright students, this covers your various types of connections, the various connections based on structural members and the design considerations according to Indian standards, the factors and the expansion joint which are provided in precast concrete structures. We will talk about the various production technology and applications in the next session. Have a good day students. Thank you.